हेलो एवरीवन, वी आर गोइंग टू सी बीट्स इन साउंड वेव एंड हियर आल्सो वी विल सी हाउ द बीट इज फॉर्म्ड, दैट इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ बीट. सी द कॉन्सेप्ट फॉर द बीट फेनोमेना. व्हेन टू प्लेन प्रोग्रेसिव वेव, दिस प्लेन प्रोग्रेसिव वेव्स मस्ट हैव साउंड वेव traveling in same direction, simultaneously, together. And there should be some characteristic of these two waves. These two waves have having approximately same frequency or wavelength. Then these two waves superimpose, mixed, combined by principle of superposition. These two waves, which having approximately same frequency, traveling in same direction simultaneously means together, they mixed up and by the principle of superposition and new wave is formed. Wave is formed. When this new wave is formed, this new wave has characteristic. What is the characteristic? The characteristic is rise and fall. Fall in intensity of sound. Sound alternately. Rise and fall, increase, first suppose increase in the intensity, increasing with the time in the intensity, goes to maximum value, then decreases at zero, then again decreases and comes to zero, then again increases, decreases, increases, decreases, is called, this property is obtained. This is called beat phenomena. This rise and fall alternatively in the intensity of sound is called beat phenomena. One rise and one fall in the intensity of sound is called one beat. One beat means one rise and one fall. This beat phenomena can clearly understand with help of this diagram. See, this is first wave traveling in this direction. See, the pen is moving in that direction. In same direction, the second wave whose displacement is y2 is also moving in same direction. Both waves one above another. The diagram is made separate, but both are moving together. Then both waves combine by principle of superposition. Their net displacement is algebraic sum of both displacement, that is y1 plus y2, and form this wave. This is called formation of a beat. Here see, since we know that intensity is directly proportional to the square of amplitude, so see here, increase means rise in the amplitude, decrease in the amplitude. Rise and fall in the is called a beat phenomena. This is one beat. Rise, fall, rise, fall. This is fall only, half beat. One beat, two beat, and one and a half. Half. This is 1 bit is here when it is come to the last, up to the 0, 1, 2, and it is half, 2.5 bit total. So rise and fall is called one beat phenomena. Now, one rise and one fall in intensity. According to diagram is called 1 beat, and number of beat per second is called beat frequency. Beat frequency denoted by this symbol. And one more thing, no beat formed. Beat formed, right? When in a condition when frequencies are exactly equal. So beat is formed only when frequencies approximately equal. In case of equal, no beat is formed. So now we are going to see theory of beat. See, in the theory I have told to you people, two sound wave having approximately equal frequency traveling in a direction and superimpose. Let equation of sound wave, first wave y1 is equal to a sine 2 pi t by t1 minus x by λ1 represented by equation number 1. Second equation y2 is equal to this plane progressive wave. Hearing it, both equation can also be written in this form, because 1 by time period we are knowing frequency n. Since y1, then y1 can be written as a sine 2 pi 1 by t is n1 t minus x by λ1. And y2 is equal to a sine 2 pi n2 t minus x by λ2, third and fourth, both combined by principle of superposition. When they both combine by principle of superposition, so principle of superposition speaks. Right? When one place a value of both, here in this diagram, this is along x-axis and displacement is along y-axis. We want to see the equation number 3 and 4. At x is equal to 0. At x is equal to 0, we want to see the equation both for y1 and y2. That is, y1 can be written as a sine 2 pi n1 t, and y2 becomes at x is equal to 0. Putting the value of x as 0, y2 becomes a sine 2 pi n 2 t, where n 1 and n 2 is frequency of interfering wave. Now putting both values in equation number 5, y is equal to a sine 2 pi n 1 t plus, this is not 2a, a sine 2 pi n 2 t. This whole can be obtained. This is solved by formula sin c plus sin d, which is 2 sin c plus d by 2 cos c minus d by 2. Let this is equation 6 and it is equation 7. By using equation 7, equation 6 can be written as, so here in this, y can be obtained 2a sine pi n1 plus n2 in 2t cosine pi n1 minus n2 in 2t here in whole of this, and by rearranging this equation can be written as 2a cos pi n1 minus n2 t into sine factor sine pi n1 plus n2 t. See, this is a resultant expression. And we may write this is equation number 8. Now see carefully here, in all this, we have summed two waves. These two waves by principle of superposition, both are sinusoidal wave. Sinusoidal sine wave. Both wave combine sinusoidal wave, and see here, the resultant is also sine wave. Sinusoidal wave. Sine wave. Y is equal to A sine omega t. Here this A is amplitude, where amplitude of resultant wave, capital A, is given by formula 2a cos pi n1 minus n2 in 2t. Right? Here in C, 2a is a constant, pi is a constant. Once we have taken two sound waves, their frequency is constant. But what is the variable here? Time. It means amplitude A is dependent on t. It means it is a variable. Variable means the amplitude is not throughout constant, and that can be seen in the diagram also. So see here in this diagram, the amplitude is increases, maximum decreases, zero increases and decreases. So it is not constant. So not constant indicate that it is a variable, and variable factor is this. Now two cases arises. Case number one. For maximum amplitude. For maximum amplitude, the variable factor, the maximum value is 1, plus minus 1. If it is plus minus 1, then we may write cos pi n1 minus n2 into t is equal to cos k pi, where k is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. All k cos k pi is either plus 1 or minus 1. Cos 0 is 1, cos pi is minus 1. Same like that alternatively. So one may write by this indicate that n1 minus n2 into t is equal to k. Pi is cancelled by pi in both sides. This implies that t is equal to k by n1 minus n2. So we may write position of maxima at k is equal to 0, 1, 2, second maxima, third maxima, 3 by n1 minus n2 and so on. These are the position of maximum intensity, right? And number of beat per second, that is called beat frequency. BF is equal to difference in their frequencies, n1 minus n2. The distance between two, time difference between two successive beats are 1 upon n1 minus n2. It is obtained how? The difference in two successive is 1 by n1 minus n2. So number of beats per second is reciprocal of that. That is n1 minus n2. A special case 2. It for minimum amplitude. Minimum amplitude means minimum intensity. Minimum intensity, the variable factor is here in this, is cos pi n1 minus n2 into t in the resultant amplitude. See in it. So minimum value of it is here, it may be 0. If it is 0, then cos k n1 minus n2 into t is equal to cos k pi by 2. All cos k pi by 2 is 0, where k is same as in a similar 0, 1, 2, 3 whole number. So this indicates that n1 minus n2 into t is equal to pi by 2. Or t is equal to k by 2, not pi by 2, k by 2. Pi is cancelled by pi. So it is k by 2 n1 minus n2. Clear it is? Now position of minimas. So position of minima we can obtain. We cannot keep value k is equal to 0 because k is equal to 0 is position of maxima. So here by keeping value of 1, the position of minima is first minima is 2. N1 minus N2, 1 by 3, N1 minus N2, 1 by 4, N1 minus N2, and so on. These are the positions of minima. Now see in the diagram. Now see the first position of minima, it is second position of minima. First position of minima is 1 by 2, N1 minus N2, and it is 1 by 3, N1 minus N2 here in this. See, it is first position, second position, at 0, the maxima in the beginning. This is a maxima. Second maxima is at 1 by n1 minus n2. 2 by n1 minus n2 and so on. So these are the position of maxima and these are the position of minima. Different rise and fall, one rise and one fall is called one beat. And the number of such beat in 1 second is called beat frequency. So this is all about the beat in sound wave, formation of beat. Here in it, thereafter, I hope you understand the topic very well. So this is for the topic only. Thank you and have a nice day to all.